Hi everyone, and welcome back to Casper's Dapp Developer Series. My name is Dylan, and today I'll be showing you how to call and query smart contracts from the browser using React and the Casper Signer. We'll be interfacing with the same smart contract that we developed and deployed in the last video, and we'll be using a lot of the same backend code in a Node.js environment that will act as an API from which we can send our deployments to the network. If you've watched the previous videos, you should already have the Casper Signer installed. If you don't, install it using the link in the description. Begin by opening up a terminal and navigating to the directory you'd like to store your project. I'll start from the home directory. Now to create a new project, run npx create React app and name your project. I'll name mine Casper Interface, but you can name it whatever you'd like. Now navigate into the directory with cd and let's install our dependencies. We'll need the Casper.js SDK. We'll need Express, Axios, and Cores. We'll be using Express to create an API that will listen for requests from the front end. We'll be using the Cores package to ensure that the responses to those requests are fulfilled with Cores headers. And we'll be using Axios to connect to the back end from the front end. Go ahead and run npm run start to ensure that React is working properly. And it looks like it is. Now go ahead and open up VS Code or your preferred editor and open a folder in the source directory. Begin by creating three new files. Call the first one query.js. Next we'll do update.js. And lastly connect.js. Now open up app.js. Go ahead and remove everything in here and replace it with a React fragment. It's just an open tag. Now let's import the files we just created and import React as well. We'll need the public key to be available to all of the components. So use the React state hook and we'll use public key and set public key. If you're not familiar with state in React, public key is initially set to null, and we can use set public key to set the public key from any of the components. When we do this, it'll trigger a re-render. Now our app is going to be very simple, so we will just place all of our components within a div tag here. Now we'll want the connect component to be able to set the public key, so we'll pass set public key in as a prop. And for update, we want it to be able to read the public key, so we'll pass in public key as a prop. Now let's move on to connect.js. First, we'll want to import the signer, as we'll be using this class to interface with the Casper signer in the browser. Now we'll set up our component, which we'll call connect, and we'll bring in the props. It'll just return a single button that, when clicked, runs the connect signer function and passes the props through. We'll write this connect signer function in a moment. Now let's write the connect signer function. So the connect signer function first checks if the signer is connected. If it's not, it'll send a connection request. If it is, it'll get the active public key and then set it. Remember, we passed in set public key from app.js. If it fails here, it'll alert the user with an error message. And if it fails here, it'll alert the user with an error message. This will often happen if the signer is locked. It'll throw an error. Now we can just export our component and we're finished here. Now let's move on to the update component. First, we'll want to import everything that we'll be using from the Casper.js SDK, and we'll also want to import Axios so we can connect with the backend that we'll be writing when we're finished writing the front end. Now we can write the update component, which is also pretty simple. We start by defining a variable named disabled. We'll set it to true. This will relate to the button as it'll be disabled by default. If the public key is not equal to null, we'll set disabled equal to false so that the button is enabled. When we click the button, it'll run send update with the public key, and we'll write this function in just a moment. To begin the sendUpdate function, we can first set it as asynchronous and to accept the public key. Then we can create a new contract object and we can set the contract hash. The contract hash will be the same as the deployed contract from the last video, which you can find by going to your account at testnet.cspr.live and going into named keys and copying the contract hash. Now we need to obtain a new message to send to the smart contract, and we'll do this by using document.querySelector, and we'll select the input that we set up earlier, and then we'll get its value. Normally you'd want to make sure that it's not null or empty, but in this case we'll just assume it isn't. Now we need to build our transaction so that we can deploy it. We'll do this by calling contract.callEntryPoint. We'll first pass in the entry point we'd like to call, which is update MSG. Now we need the runtime arguments, which we can build from a map. we'll say message to clValueBuilder.stringValue. We actually need to build this into a CL value, even though this is already a string. Then we use clPublicKey.fromHexPublicKey. This is the public key that's coming from the Casper signer. We need to build it into a CL public key object. Then we select the network name. In this case, it's Casper Test. If you were using the mainnet, it would be just Casper. And then the gas payment. This is 1 billion motes or 1 CSPR. As is, this is a deploy object from the Casper.js SDK. And we need to convert that into JSON so we can send it to our backend. So we can use deployutil.deployToJSON and pass in the deploy. Now that we have our JSON deploy, we can go about signing it and sending it off to the backend. So first we'll initiate a signer request with the JSON deploy and the public key. This will open up the Casper signer and initiate a request for you to sign. Then we can send this to the backend at the endpoint update MSG. We'll send the signed deploy and the headers will just be content type application JSON. Now just export your component and we can move on to query.js. Query.js is probably the simplest of them all. First, we'll just import Axios as we'll need to call the backend. Then we can actually write our component in which we'll pass in the props and just have a single button that calls query message. Lastly, we'll just need the query message function, which calls the backend at the endpoint query MSG and then alerts the user with the response. Export the component. And let's move on to the backend. Create a new file, server.js. And in this file, we'll first import our dependencies. We'll need Express. We'll set up our Express app. We'll require cores. We'll set up our port, which I'll use 3001. You can use any port you'd like. And we'll need all of these objects from the Casper.js SDK. We'll tell our Express app to use the JSON middleware and set up cores headers. Now we'll need to instantiate a new Casper client object with an RPC URL. You can find online peers by going to testnet.cspr.live/tools/peers or just cspr.live if you're on the mainnet. Look for any peer ending in 35,000, copy the IP address, head back over, paste it in, replace the port with 7777, and add /RPC. Just like in update.js, we can set up a contract object and set the contract hash to the contract hash of our smart contract. The difference in this case you'll notice is that the client is actually being passed into the contract object. So as soon as we make queries with the contract object, it will send it through the Casper client. Let's set up our first endpoint, which will be a post endpoint at update MSG. This will also be an asynchronous callback function. To handle sending the deployment to the network, we'll first set up a try-catch block. We'll use deployutil.deployfromJSON. We'll pass in the post body, and we'll unwrap the deploy into an actual deploy object from the Casper.js SDK. Then we will send that deploy to the network using the client.putDeploy method, and we'll send the deploy hash back to the user on the front end. To handle querying the message, we can set up a new endpoint that we'll label query_msg. This will be a GET request instead of a POST request, but it's still asynchronous. We will send back to the front end the result of this contract.queryContractData function, and we'll pass in the named key message. And this message argument refers to the message named key within the smart contract. Finally, all we need to do is tell our Express app to listen on the port that we specified, and we're finished. To test that everything's working, make sure all your files are saved. Head over and open two terminals. In the first one, run node src/server.js. And in the other, run npm run start. If everything worked correctly, you should see this basic web app pop up on your browser at port 3000. If we click connect signer, you'll notice we get an error. It says, please unlock the signer to read key. So if we open the signer and unlock our vault, and then click connect signer again, you'll notice that the update message button becomes enabled. Now if we run query message, you'll see it says hello world, and that matches what we see if we go to the named key message and click on the uref. We see the value hello world. Now let's try updating the message. We'll write a new message. I'll say hello again. We'll click update message. It'll initiate a signature request. I'll sign the message. You'll see that we get a deploy hash. We can take this deploy hash, copy it, paste it here, and wait for it to complete. Once the execution succeeds, we can head back to our React app, query the message, and you'll see it says hello again. We can verify this by going back to cspr.live, going back, and we see it says hello again. That's all for this video. If you found it useful, click the like button, consider subscribing, and turn on the notifications with the bell button if you'd like to be notified when new videos are released. In the description, you'll find a link to the GitHub repository for this project. If you have any questions, be sure to reach out to us on Discord. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next video.